Oh, it's very tough. It took a long time to get there and find something. I'm always searching and trying to find something. It's a challenge, especially in this kind of genre. Like, I love genre films, but I like to try and find something that still is fresh about them. And that's the big challenge. There's plenty of, you know, crime thrillers out there, but in terms of material, but this one just had a fantastic, the whole idea of a 999 I hadn't heard of before, and it created this very rich moral dilemma. So yeah, that was very fortunate. Yeah, that was a real challenge. And juggling that many parts and how they all fit was a real challenge. But what was amazing about, and I was really blessed with this cast, is the commitment and the way that each of them had their own way of taking on the world that they came from, you know, because we're dealing with an extreme world. Like, in just using Chiwetel as an example, do you remember the Navy SEALs trainer was basically said, you know, if he does want to change profession, come to us. Because he'd been training for months.
Have you been
We went out to the shooting range and saw him in action, and I was like,
has that tempted you, Chiwetel?
Yeah. Give up this game.
Exactly.
Get in a war.
You heard it here first.
Oh, well, where do I begin? actually, there was just a little bit here and there. They'll be on the DVD as deleted extras. We actually changed this man's murder scene. Is that a plot spoiler?
I won't spoil it.
Yeah, I think it works much better, and we're putting in the old version on the DVDs. That's what I do, is just the other material I kind of just leave on the for people to discover and work out. But of course, there's inevitably stuff that has to be pruned, and it's a balancing act and very difficult decisions. And I hope no one holds it against me. I take violence very seriously. I grew up in America in a very turbulent time as a young kid. I've seen violence, I've been a victim of violence, and I take it very seriously, and I think there's basically no one comes out unscathed. There's no victors, it's not black and white. And that's why I try, and there's always an element of chaos. So I try to be truthful about it, and it's more about what builds up to it and what follows it. And I think you can see that in the film. Now, the idea was to create a film that was also very contemporary and showing how America is now in this world, that where all the stakes have been raised right across the board, you know, including the police, the militarization, and the kind of, you know, they have their own, you know, SWAT training, and everything's been ramped up. You know, the days, in fact, in the criminal world, looking back on the Italian mafia, those were like the good old days when things were, you know, pretty quiet and peaceful. Well, I love genres that put characters under pressure, because for me that creates conflict, and I like to do a lot of research, and a lot of these genres are extreme worlds, so it sort of goes with the territory. But my children's film and my romantic comedy is coming. I was just so used to seeing, especially dealing with police, the colour blue. You know, we even changed the police lights to amber and red as much as we could control. And also crime, the crime world, a lot of this type of film, you know, was New York-based or East Coast-based. Of course, West Coast has its own thing going on. But it also did to do, deal with Atlanta, you know, the heat. It was sort of hot.
Was sort it? Of yeah. Hot, yeah.
And so to enhance that, and also, but mainly to just, yeah, color is very powerful. Red's a very emotional color. I just wanted to avoid, in this genre, blue, I felt, was had its day. So we intentionally try to avoid all blue. I think it helps. I have enormous respect for actors because they are the ones at the end of the day that have to, in that instant, try and get the truth, and they're what you're really looking at. And to under that pressure of time and, you know, schedules and all the rest going on, to be able to do that is an extraordinary thing. And I think to share, you know, what the movie is, to you know, help in any way, I'm very glad to hear that, Kate, because I think when you have all these separate groups, and especially with an ensemble, but I do it on all films because I feel, and likewise with the crew, if it's more of a shared experience, everyone can contribute. And everyone did, you know, like respond. You have something then to respond to as opposed to just, you know, kind of all these pockets.